Let's work through a CVP income statement example problem. So this problem wants us to prepare a CVP income statement, or a cost volume profit income statement, using the information that we were given below. So we're given units sold, unit selling price, total variable, and total fixed cost amounts. So that information will be over on the left side as we start to fill out our CVP income statement. Now, this relationship is very important to know. Sales minus variable cost equals contribution margin. Then, contribution margin minus your fixed costs will equal net income. So let's start plugging in the information that we were given over there on the left. So our unit selling price, that's $50. Total variable was $22,000, and total fixed was $15,000. Then we can start solving for the other pieces here. Like our total sales. Well, we're selling each unit for $50. We're selling a total of 1,000 units. We multiply those two together, and we see that our total sales amount is $50,000. Our variable cost per unit. Well, our total variable cost was $22,000, and we sold 1,000 units. So we divide those two amounts, and we see that our variable cost per unit was $22,000. Now, our total contribution margin. This is where knowing this relationship comes in handy, knowing that your sales minus your variable costs equal contribution margin. Because we take the $50,000 minus $22,000, and that gets us our $28,000. We can do the same thing over in the per unit side. We take 50 minus 22 to give us 28. Then our net income, we take our contribution margin minus our fixed costs to get us our net income of $13,000. Now if we take a look over at the ratio column, so sales is going to be 100% because it's 100% of itself. But once we move on to variable costs, how can we solve for this? Well, there's a couple different ways. We can take the 22,000 divided by 50,000, which is our total variable costs divided by our total sales. Or you could also take your variable cost per unit of 22 divided by your unit selling price of 50. So it's your variable cost divided by sales. Either way, you're going to end up with 44%. So your variable costs are 44% of your sales. Now your contribution margin ratio. A few different ways that you can solve for this one. You could take your $28,000 contribution margin divided by $50,000 in sales. You could take 28, which is your contribution margin per unit, divided by your unit selling price of 50. Or we can remember that your sales minus variable costs equal contribution margin. So 100% minus 44% equals 56%. And that 56% is your contribution margin ratio.